Великий Господь, і Царь великий Божий. Спаси нас, Сину Божий, що воскрес із мертвих, співаємо тобі, Аллилуйя.
Премудрість просим.
Прийдіть, поклонімося і припадім до Христа. Спаси нас, Сину Божий, що воскрес із мертвих, співаємо тобі, Аллилуйя.
Oh, yeah. from the letters of St. Paul to the Ephesians.
Let us be attentive.
Brothers and sisters, God is rich in mercy. Because of his great love for us, he brought us to life with Christ when we were dead in sin. But this favor you were saved, both with and in Christ Jesus, he raised us up and gave us a place in the heavens, that in the ages to come he might display the great wealth of his favor, manifested by his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. I repeat, it is owing to his favor that salvation is yours through faith. This is not your own doing. It is God's gift. Neither is it a reward for anything you have accomplished. So let no one pride himself on it. We are truly his handiwork, created in Christ to lead the life of good deeds which God prepared for us in advance.
Читання з послання святого апостола Павла до Ефесян.
Будьмо уважні.
Браття, Бог багатий милосердям, з великої своєї любові, якої полюбив нас, мертвих нашими гріхами, оживив нас разом із Христом, благодаттю в спасенні, і разом із ним воскресив нас, і разом посадив на небі у Христі Ісусі, щоб у майбутніх віках він міг показати надзвичайне багатство своєї благодаті у своїй доброті до нас, у Христі Ісусі. Бо ви спасені благодаттю через віру, і це не від нас. Воно дар Божий, не від діл, щоб ніхто не міг похвалитися. Бо ми його сотворіння, сотворені у Христі Ісусі для добрих діл, який Бог уже наперед був приготував, щоб ми чинили.
Не тобі примудись, будьмо уважні. He did not live in the house, but among the tombstones. On seeing Jesus, he began to shrink. Then the man fell at the feet of Jesus and exclaimed at the top of his voice, Jesus, Son of God, Most High, why do you meddle with me? Do not torment me, I beg you. By now, Jesus was always ordering the unclean spirit to come out of the man. The spirit had taken hold of him many at a time. The man used to be tied with chains and fetters, but he would break his bonds and the demon would drive him into the place of solitude. What is your name? Jesus demanded. Legion, he answered. Because the demons who had entered him were many. They pleaded with Jesus not to order them back to the Hades. It happened that a large herd of swine was feeding nearby on a hillside, and the demons asked Jesus to permit them to enter the swine. This he granted. The demons then came out of the man and entered the swine, and the herd charged down the block into the lake where they drowned. When the swine herds saw what happened, they took to their heels and brought the news to the town and the country round about. The people went out to see for themselves what had happened. Coming to Jesus, they found the man from whom the devils had departed, sitting at the feet of Jesus, dressed and in his full senses. This sight terrified them. They were told by witnesses how the possessed man had been cured. Shortly afterward, the entire population of the Gerasene territory asked Jesus to leave their neighborhood, for the great fear had seized them. So he got into the boat and went back across the lake. The men from whom the devils had departed asked to come with Jesus, but Jesus sent him away with the words, "Go back home and recount all that God has done for you." The men went all through the town, making public what Jesus had done for him. Collecting money to buy coats for children in our city to help for families who are not able to buy the winter coats for their children. So there is a basket at Knights of Columbus. You're more than welcome, you know, to at the sign table to make your donations. And then when I checked our website, you know, I was actually surprised, pleasantly surprised. Our website is visited these over 500 times a month. So for a little parish, so many people do come and visit with the bulletin and so on. So saying that, if you know, I was thinking about, why not, you know, church is also in need of, or the parish always extra funds or something. So I was thinking about, you know, many parishes in the bulletin, they advertise, you know, local businesses. So if you would, if you know of someone who would like to, I would probably create a separate page for, you know, for local businesses to advertise on our website. And so more than welcome, spread the news around, and then I'm not sure what would be proper even, but I can discuss that with potential, you know, business who would like to, but of course has to be something that I can advertise by church. So without, you know, send me, you know, local businesses that are kind of on the opposite church teaching. So again, so if you know someone, please send them, tell them more than welcome to give me a call, and then I'd like to create you know, the page for local businesses to advertise. Name the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. What is your name? It's very, it's not an uncommon question. You know, you would say, "Hello, my name is Maria," or you know, Vincent, or "My name is Carlos. What is your name?" It's one of the first ways to begin to know another person. It helps to know others people, because it is like a hook on the door that we can begin to hang all their information, personal information and stories, in order to remember that person. Once we know another's person name well, we often don't think consciously about using it, but it becomes the very word that brings everything about them into the forefront of our mind when we use it. Let me just mention a few names and consider how information flows through our prefrontal cortex, our thinking brain. If I would say mom, you know, you'd go right away to, you know, perhaps picture of your mom or dad, or, you know, brother or sister, or a child or grandchildren if you're old enough. And then, you know, right away behind that name, a face comes with, not just the face, you know, with stories and everything. And then, you know, we remember the birthday or we remember, you know, stories about that person. So each one of those names brings a unique person to mind for each of us. Certainly the same would be true with the names perhaps not so like, or what you would consider them enemies. What is your name? So this is the same question that Jesus asks in today's gospel reading to the man from that gardenies. Except Jesus is not asking the man's name. In fact, we never learn the real name of that man. Instead, Jesus is asking the demons who possess the man, what is your name? And we hear the answer, Legion. Because as the gospel says, many demons had entered him. So this is really an important but often overlooked element of this gospel story. What I call the naming of the demons, because it is the beginning of the healing process towards reconciliation with God. Before we proceed, it is really important to remember that demon possession from the Christian perspective does not look even close to what you see on television or reading the paper or, I'm sure, some horror movies and so on. They often portray humans as powerless against demons and depict demonic possession as a violent experience and requisite exorcism in overly dramatic fashion. But in truth, the devil and the demons are much more cunning and crafty. Their method is subtle, and they like to work in secret so they can silently begin to influence us. They watch us, they examine us. They know our weaknesses and which temptation worked best against us. All that is required of us is to slowly make small decisions that turn us away from God, even if only a thought in mind. If this pattern continues, then gradually the demons will have more and more influence over us, including our thoughts, words, and deeds. They will take whatever they can get in their long war to take possession of the soul. So returning to the naming the demons, the most dramatic example of this process would be the following. Sometimes when a person is abused, and we've heard that, you know, in Canada, you know, in our cities, maybe even in our families, at a very young age, in order to protect themselves from the severe pain, mental and emotional and physical harm that was done to a child, he or she will repress the memory of the event and the person who perpetrated the abuse. This is often one of the only ways the child can deal with the pain. As they grow older, the memory is forgotten, but the emotional pain is still buried deep within. So the pain will cause them to think, speak, and act in many times self-destructive ways. Relationships with others suffer too. The reasons why seem inexplicable until one begins to slowly and courageously look back and to look within. If they can feel safe and secure enough with another person they trust, they can begin to experience the pain by naming it, and naming the person who perpetrated it. It is like rising that young, innocent child from the dead to a new life so that he or she can be integrated with their adult person. In this case, the demon entered through the abusive actions of another person. The not-so-dramatic example that applies to most of us is, as I said before, we make many, many decisions every single day. Almost every single decision either brings us closer to God or further away from God. In Greek, sin is amartia, or is to miss the mark. Christ is the target. Are we directed towards Him? Are we moving towards Him? Or if our decisions turn us away from Him or move us further away from Him, they are amartia or a sin. So in some sense, many situations that we find ourselves in can be defined as temptations, environments that lure us to sin. The sad fact of living in this really broken and fallen world is that it is easier, much easier to sin than not to sin. But you know, the world portrays sin as, you know, absolutely, you should take care of yourself. This is what you deserve, you know, to, you know, whatever, feel good and all that stuff. So our life can become like a snowball rolling down a hill. It gathers more mass. It rolls faster as it goes and becomes more difficult to stop. And in our extremely busy lives, we begin to lose sight of how the devil and the demons are working against us. We forget how we got into the mess we find ourselves in. We struggle to make the first step to stop this downhill avalanche our life has become. We're like the swine in today's gospel running down the steep hill to drown in the lake, to be drowned in the lake. So what's the solution? Of course, you know, this is something that might happen or perhaps is happening. What's the solution? Name the demons. How do we name the demons that possess us? Simple answer is confession. Is our Catholic way to name those demons. Confessing to God our sins is naming the demons. Confessing our passions, our weaknesses, and our sinful inclinations is naming the demons. Even at times naming the people who serve to bring temptations and sin into our life is naming the demons. Even though they brought them in, it is our responsibility to cast them out. Yeah, I wish it were this easy. Unfortunately, I see far too many people who still carry their demons around with them, either because they are unable to name the demons or they are unwilling. That's why we have the sacrament of reconciliation, confession. The priest knows how to help us to deal with our passions and our weaknesses. He knows how to stop this snowball, how to stop the avalanche, and get us back on the safe, level path. So he knows how to name the demon. So let's pray that we will be strong enough and to name those demons and use this powerful tool, the sacrament of reconciliation, again, again, and again. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to Christ.
Let us all say with our whole soul, whole mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to the fathers, we pray you hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, in the great and your compassion, we pray you hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Also pray for our most holy universal Pontiff Francis, Pope Rome, King Jan, Patriots of the Twelve, most reverend of all the Lords, and God, loving Bishop Brian, for those who have served His Holy Church, spiritual Father, Lord, Brother, in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
час і на віки вічні.
Thank you. from the Father and the Son.
With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the cross. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I want the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Let us then dwell, let us then with heroes be attentive, to offer in peace to their holy oblation.
Thank you.
descend down on us in the return of His grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
The Holy Peace was sinless, let's ask the Lord. Save your people, God, and bless your inheritance.
We have seen the joy.
Thank you.
Be our protection against your wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke you and help you, pray. And to the Prince of the Heavenly Hosts, by the power of God, cast us into heavenly Satan, O evil spirits, who wander throughout the world, speaking good.